The biggest problem confronting children today is self-identity, knowing who they are, knowing that it's okay to be set apart and to be a leader instead of a follower.
A lot of girls, they take selfies all the time. It's a thing. And they'll look at their phone and they'll be like, oh, I'm so ugly. And you look at them, you're like, why do you feel that way? Like, what standard are we putting on you? So I think the biggest challenges they see lie in themselves. So if I can, as a staff, do anything for them, it's to make them see, you know, you are beautiful. Like, if I can set that positive role model tone for you, then if that's the only thing I do for you before you leave this club, then I'll consider my career success.
Well, I was kind of shy, just because I'm shy to new places sometimes. And I thought, you know, I could get into the mess that some people were in, and I could be in the drama, and I could want to be in everybody's business. But I really was able to come in and open up and just introduce myself to everyone. And the staff, they were really welcoming, and I really felt at home coming here.
Taya has transformed tremendously. Her maturity level is out of this world. She's never really been a follower. I've watched her closely. She's always been a leader. She's always been her own person. And that's what draws people to her. She's like a magnet for her generation.
Back in seventh and eighth grade, I had a lot of anger issues. A lot was going on, and so I ended up starting to have to go to therapy. And
first day that I walked into the door, I was shy and nervous, but I knew that I was going to end up making friends, and so I really loved the place as soon as I walked in.
If anybody has had the chance to meet Tony or get to know Tony or know anything about his story, you would wonder how he is where he is today. To get to be a part of watching him grow and to see him shine and grow into the person that, I mean, he's going to change the world. So getting to be a part of that is fantastic.
I've grown up a lot because I was kind of immature when I first walked in, because I was still a little kid. I was still in junior high and I hadn't grown up yet. And then now I feel like I've grown into more of a man.
They were like a family. All the kids were like a family. So it really changed my mindset of being in mess and being in drama and thinking that social media and everything was the life, and it really wasn't. And the Boys and Girls Club showed me that.
There's just astronomical resources here at the Boys and Girls Club that kids get to be a part of.
It's just a positive place, a safe haven for children to come, to have fun, to feel loved and encouraged in this atmosphere where there's a lot of opportunity.
I'm a mom, I'm a counselor, I'm a, you know, a friend, I'm a confidant, I'm whatever those kids need, along with all of my coworkers, whatever club that they work at. We take on and wear so many hats that, I mean, I'm proud to wear, honestly.
Children are growing up in a world they don't fully understand. They feel lost, alone, invisible, scared. But we can lend a hand. They can be strong, beautiful, confident, intelligent. For over 56 years, Boys and Girls Clubs of the Midlands have helped kids in our community reach their full potential, and with our help, they can rise.